to the second episode of Cooking Solo, where it's fun to eat alone. Today our recipe comes from one of my favorite regions in the world, Italy. Today we'll be making Parmigiano Reggiano Crusted Chicken Breast on a bed of linguine. Parmigiano Reggiano is basically a cheese that's from the regions of Parma and Reggiano Emilio in Italy. It's called Parmigiano Reggiano because it's produced by this area. But since we're not using Parmigiano Reggiano, we're just using regular Parmesan made in the United States. We're making really Parmesan crusted chicken breasts. I hope you really enjoy this one. I love it. Let's get started. Here's what you'll need. All right, so this recipe is really short. It takes about a half an hour max. So what we're gonna do first is we're gonna start getting the water boiling for the pasta. For this, you're gonna need about 1 liter of water. All right, let's go get some water in our pot. All right, here's our pot, and we're just gonna go to the sink. We're gonna run about 1 liter of water in that pot. Alright, I'd say this is about 1 liter of water, probably a little too much. Alright, that should be good. Alright, now we're going to run it over to the stove. Now what I've noticed is with electric stoves is that it's not all the time that you turn it on and it just pops right up. So what my mother did was she bought this little ingenious device. I'm telling you, it's a lifesaver. It's called an igniter. It's an electric igniter. So what you do is you just flip the gas on, press this little button here, pops right up. The flame pops right up. So what we're going to do now, we're going to cover this water and let it boil. Let's turn the fire up a little bit. And we're going to let that boil. Now we're back over to our station where we have our chicken breasts, our linguine. We have all the other ingredients that we're going to need. What we're gonna do now is take out the chicken and we're gonna start prepping the chicken. So I'll see you back in a little bit. All right, here I am again. And we have got our beautiful, beautiful chicken breast. Oh, doesn't this chicken breast look just beautiful? All right. The seasoning for this chicken breast is really, really simple, and we're not taking it to any extremes. We're not adding a super load of flavors, because what we really want to do is get the flavor of the Parmesan in the crusting. So we're not going to add too many flavors. We just want the chicken to be juicy and succulent and flavorful, but we don't want to overdo it. So here we have the chicken. All right, and we're going to do is get a little bit of this all-purpose seasoning. I love this all-purpose seasoning. You wouldn't even know. And you're just gonna take about a tablespoon, all right? And you're gonna tablespoon the front, tablespoon to the front. You wanna rub that in. I'm telling you, you have to love your food. So you just rub that in, all right? Back, same thing, tablespoon. Don't mind that it's getting all over the plate. No worries. And you want to just get into these little creases in the chicken. All right? Wonderful. And you want to rub it in so you get all that's supposed to be there. All right. Now, to this, we're going to add a little bit of salt, which will also give it a fantastic flavor. So, here we have some salt. All right. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to pour the salt to the side so that we don't really, so really don't overdo it. Right? All right, so there we have about 2 tablespoons of salt there. It actually looks like a little too much, but no worries. And just sprinkle it on. You know, tablespoon to the front, tablespoon to the back. All right? You want to rub that in? Chicken already has zero flavor by itself, so don't worry that you're adding too much salt or too much of the other flavoring. Flip the chicken. get some salt on the back here. Probably put a little too much there. It's no problem. Yeah, should be good. All right, that's nice. It's really good. Now you see we have a little excess salt over there. So what we're just gonna do is grab another plate real quick, and we're just gonna switch it out. Yeah, don't want your salt, your food being excessively salty, so we're gonna put that in the sink. And to this, we're gonna add a little bit of another one of my really, really favorite ingredients, some soy sauce. What the soy sauce does is give the chicken a little bit of color. You don't wanna overdo it again. Here we go. Teaspoon on the front. A little more. Teaspoon on the front. And just to give it a little color. Everything you do on the front, you gotta do it on the back. Teaspoon on the back. Alright. And remember, you really have to rub it in. Rub it in. Rub it in. Alright. Alright. Now, to this chicken, usually it's really, the ingredients that are really popular are salt and pepper. I like to do salt and all-purpose seasoning, because all-purpose seasoning has some really, really good ingredients, like it has coriander seed, garlic powder, celery flavoring, onion powder. It really is all-purpose, and it has, it's almost like an all-spice without actually being an all-spice. So we have the chicken there. Now to this chicken, I thought I would do something a little interesting, which was take just a little bit, a really small amount of garlic. So that's one clove of garlic grated. You want to just rub that in. Rub it in. All right, look at, right, you're rubbing it in. Look at that. Flip the back. What you do to the front, you got to do to the back. All right. And get the garlic. Rub it in. That's one clove of garlic. Now that you have the chicken prepped, what you're gonna need to do now is get the crusting for the chicken. This is the piece de resistance of the meal, which is the Parmesan crust. See you soon. Alright, chicken is prepped, water is boiling. Let us get to the meat of the matter. Or in this case, the crust of the chicken. Parmesan crusted chicken breast. Usually people like to use breadcrumbs, but I'm a weirdo in my own right, so I like to use cornflakes. I think cornflakes give it an extra crunch that's really delicious and wonderful, and I really enjoy really crushing the cornflakes. It gives me a lot of joy. All right, so what we're gonna do first is we're gonna crush the cornflakes. All right, here we have. And what you're gonna do is you're just gonna take it, crunch it, really enjoy cooking your food. All right, so here we go. Ooh, this is so fun. It's like when you're a child and you like to just crush your crackers or something. I really enjoy just doing this. It gives me a lot of joy. So, there we go. Still crushing it. You want to get this as fine as you can. And if your hands aren't sufficing, you could get a spoon, something else, whatever you want to do. As long as you get it crushed out. I like to break it with my fingers because it's very fun. So here we are, still crushing. All right. So now that we've crushed it out a little bit with our hands, let's just get a spoon, which will help us. And what you're gonna do is you're just gonna use the spoon and press and press and press. Yep. But the spoon is here for. The spoon is here to help. And if you don't want to use a spoon anymore, take your hands again and just crush. brush. Try and get it as small pieces as possible. Don't worry that you're making a mess. Cooking is fun. When you're done, clean it up. I'm gonna get the pieces as, you know, as fine as you want it. This is so fun. You have no idea. All right. I'm gonna get just a little bit finer for me, because I like it to have that crunch, as I was saying. So, oops, making such a mess. This is so fun. As in, if you are like a lonely, bored college student, or you just need to take out some aggression, get some cornflakes, crush it out. I didn't want to do it before so that you guys didn't know what I was doing. But here's what you're going to do. Alright? Alright. Getting the cornflakes, crushing out. Ooh. It's like a... I'm making a mess! But it's exciting. And I'm enjoying myself. Alright. Alright, this is done. Now to this, what you're going to do is take some of this Parmesan cheese. I like Sargento. Some people might like another brand. Use whatever you like. And you're going to add half a cup of this. Okay. Quarter cup, half a cup, half a cup. Yeah, let's stick with the original. And you got the Parmesan in there. Take the spoon and incorporate it. Take the spoon and incorporate the corn flakes and the Parmesan. Once you're done with this, all that's left now is the linguine. And you're going to have a wonderful meal. Alright, so got the Parmesan and the corn flakes all incorporated. And this is going to work as our crust. It's really, really get it really, really good. Let's really get it incorporated. Alright. Nice. Alright. So we've made the crust for our chicken breast, which is already seasoned and raring to go. So the next step now is to put the pasta in the water, because the water should be boiling by now. So we're going to put the pasta in there, and then we're going to crust the chicken breast, pop that in the oven, and then we'll be ready to go. So the next step is to put the pasta in the water. See you soon. All right, welcome back. We're going to put our linguine in our pot. This is about 2 ounces of linguine. I know it doesn't really look like anything, but remember, pasta, when it's boiled, expands, so you really want to put less than you want when it's cooked. So we're gonna head over to the pot now. Here we are by the pot. That water is boiling. Amazing. All right. To this pot, we're going to add about a tablespoon of salt, because we don't want our linguine to be too dry. So we're going to, or, you know, tasteless. So we're going to add about a tablespoon of salt to this. All right, great. Now, I have seen several commercials where they want you to buy something that cooks your pasta straight so that you don't have to break it up. Rubbish. Absolute rubbish. If you want your pasta this length, you don't need to buy a machine that makes it this length or some kitchen apparatus that makes it this long. You don't have to break it either to fit it in a pot. I'm going to show you what you're going to do. What you're going to do is you're going to take the linguine and you're going to put it in the pot. See? What you're going to do is you're going to slowly bend it. You're going to slowly, slowly, really slowly bend it, because you don't want it to break. But as the water hits it, the linguine is beginning to soften, because Of course, it has to soften for you to get the pasta. So what you're going to do is bend it. Just continue to bend it. Bend it whichever way you want. Bend it, bend it, bend it. Oh, all right. Bend it, bend it. You want to be careful with this part because you don't want to get your hands in the water. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get a fork to help me bend it so that I don't have to touch the water. All right? And you're just going to push the linguine down. Like that. All right? Just push it down. Take this little piece here that's sticking up. Push it down. Two little pieces there being all ignorant. All right? And just like that. Now the linguine is sitting in the pot, boiling straight. You didn't have to break it. You didn't have to buy anything. You just took the pot. You waited a little bit of time for it to melt, to soften out. And now it's in the pot, straight as day. So what we're going to do now is we're going to cover it. You don't want to cover it all the way because pasta bubbles over. So you're just going to leave a little bit of a gap right here so that the pressure can escape. And there you have it. The pasta is being cooked. Probably going to take about 15 minutes for the pasta to get cooked. So what we're going to do now is we're going to crust the chicken breast and pop it in the oven so everything will be ready within about 5 minutes or so of each other. Right? So we're going to go crust the chicken breast now. All right. See you soon. Alright, we're ready to crust the chicken breast. For this, you're going to need 3/4 cup of milk. People like to use eggs. I like to use milk. I'm a weirdo again in my own right. So you're going to need 3/4 cup of milk. You're going to need your chicken breast. And you're going to need the crusting that you made earlier. Alright, so what you're going to do is you're going to need a little bowl like this. And you're going to take your milk and put 3/4 cup of milk in a bowl, in this bowl. You just want enough milk to be able to, you know, get the crust really well on. All right, here we have the milk. Here we have our crusting, so let's just set up the station. Here we have our original plate, which I washed. And here we have our chicken breast. You want to take the chicken breast, dip it in the milk, spin it in the milk, spin it in the milk, spin it in the milk. Then you want to do, take it in the crusting, shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it. All right. Flip the chicken so that you get the some on the front. Shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it like a salt shaker. Alright? Alright? Now, what you want to do is you want to get a spoon. And for those areas that you didn't get to when you were shaking it, you just want to spoon it on. Yeah? Shaking doesn't always get everything. And the areas that are, you know, have a gap like this. Take some of that, put it on those areas that has a gap. I mean, I like to use my fingers because I feel like my fingers get everything done easier. So, there we go. Put it on. Yeah. Shake it again. Yep. I'm gonna really get that going good. Right? Get that going good. Whatever areas, sprinkle it, press it, do what you gotta do. Alright? Here we go. Isn't that great? This takes such a small amount of time. It's such a good meal in such a short amount of time. It's fantastic. Alright? So, here we have our chicken breast crusted. crusted. Beautiful crusting. Alright? Now, just to make sure, just to make sure, what I like to do is I like to add just a little bit more Parmesan on the top. But we're not going to get to that yet. First, we'll have to take a baking tray. You want to put some foil on it. Usually I don't use foil because it's Teflon and nonstick. So, we have our baking tray out. And to this, we're just going to add about a tablespoon of vegetable oil, just where you're going to get the chicken. Add that. And just, like I said, love to do everything with my hands. Just rub it. Wherever you think the chicken might touch, just rub it. Alright. Now that we've got our baking tray, we're going to get our chicken back over here. And we're going to pop our chicken onto the baking tray. Doesn't that look great? As I was explaining earlier, just to ensure, I like to get a little bit more of my Parmesan cheese onto my chicken. I'm going to use the sprinkler or the shaker side of it, like that. And I'm just going to shake a little extra Parmesan cheese right on it. Right on it, just a little extra, about 4 tablespoons. And then we're going to pop this in the oven. Alright, awesome. Popping that in the oven. And we're going to set our oven at 325. And we're going to do this for about 25 minutes. The linguine is all done, so what we're gonna do now is we're gonna plate it. Alright, let's just traipse on over to the stove. And here, I have a pair of tongs and the plate on which we're gonna be serving it. We're just gonna pop this open. There the linguine is, looking beautiful. And we're just gonna take the tongs because we don't want the water. We're just gonna lift the linguine. And we're just going to start plating the linguine. Alright? Get as much of this excess water off as possible. Oopsie. Oopsie. And start plating the linguine. Alright? Alright? We have some more linguine. Just don't want it to fall. Because I'm ridiculously clumsy, but it's alright. Can cook. God bless for that. Alright, and there we have the linguine on the plate. Alright, and the linguine is nice and beautiful. Alright, there we have the linguine on the plate. Alright, there's the linguine on the plate. And we're just gonna set the linguine down for a little bit, and when we come back in just a little bit, we're gonna take the chicken out of the oven, put it on the bed of linguine, and we're going to have an awesome meal. All right, catch you back in a little bit. All right, our chicken breast is done. So what we're going to do now is we're going to take our trusty oven mitt and we're going to pop it out of the oven, pop the chicken breast off the baking tray and get it onto our bed of linguine. And we're going to love it. We're going to enjoy eating it whether we're alone. It's going to be awesome. Let's get to it. All right. Taking my trusty oven mitt. All right. All right. Let's get this oven open. There, we have our Parmesan crusted chicken breast. All right, that's good. All right, here we go. I'm gonna just pop the baking tray onto the counter. We're gonna use these tongs, which I like so much. Let's just uncover this linguine that's been sitting here for just a few minutes. And let's just pop the chicken breast onto our bed of linguine. So we have our Parmesan crusted chicken breast on our bed of linguine. Doesn't that look good? It looks so good. All right. After this, we're going to take a bite. We're going to enjoy it. I know I'm going to enjoy it. And I know you're going to enjoy it when you do this. So when we get back, we're going to take a bite of our Parmesan crusted chicken on our bed of linguine. And it's going to be great. All right. Hi, welcome to Lisa Rooms's tip for the week. All pasta is not created equal. It really bothers me when people call every kind of pasta macaroni. It just isn't macaroni. There are several different variations of pasta. Just to name a few, there's macaroni, elbow macaroni, macaroni shells, there's fusilli, there's fettuccine, there's linguine, there's vermicelli. There are several types of pasta. So when you're thinking about pasta, don't only think about macaroni. It's not all the same. This has been the tip for the week. We're finally done, and now got my fork. We're going to eat. All right, what I did was I took the benefit of cutting it just so you could see how juicy and succulent the chicken is. All right, time to pop chicken in my mouth.
That is good. The chicken is juicy. The chicken is flavorful. The crusting is delicious.
Now let's get a little bit of the linguine. Just a little bit of this here linguine.
That is good. The linguine is al dente. It's wonderful. The chicken is juicy. It's the crust is amazing. And I'm gonna leave you guys now to go make your own while I enjoy mine. So come back next week. We'll have something totally new, something totally excited. And remember, there is no shame in eating alone. Tune in next week to Cooking Solo.